I previously mentioned that you could create a program loop to update values, but I need to expand on this further and demonstrate an extremely common issue. We are going to display the time in a text object. To be very specific, since we're operating in JavaScript, this will be the time on the client, not necessarily on the server. If you need a display for the exact time on the server, I recommend creating a psycode variable tag on the server to store the current time, but that's a topic for another video. As we always do, let's start with a text object with a script attached to it. We're going to loop on this forever, so we only need to call the function onDocumentLoad. Inside the script, I'll store off the text object's element. At this point, I have a few options to create the update loop. If I just use an infinite while loop, it will consume my client's resources. In other languages, you would use a sleep function to delay the loop, but that's not available in JavaScript. Instead, I'll call a new function, setInterval. This takes several arguments. First is the callback function to call, and I'll just say callback and write this in a moment. Next is how often to run the function in milliseconds. 1000 milliseconds will update the time fast enough for my needs. Any additional arguments will be passed on to my callback function. I need to know what element to configure, so I'll pass that text object. Please note that the system guide does refer to setInterval as a custom TGML function, but that it has been replaced by the JavaScript standard. The documentation here only refers to the form of setInterval that takes a string argument. I'm instead using the callback form as it's recommended for security reasons, but that will bite us in a moment. Now to write that callback. It will take a single argument, element, and all we need to do is set the content attribute of the element. For that, I'll use the date object. This has many options, but when called as a function like this, it returns the current date and time formatted as a string. That's all that's needed to set the time, so let's check the preview. Nothing is updated here. And I have a new error in the console. The problem is that, while this is technically valid JavaScript, the preview engine does not pass additional arguments to the callback function. I can verify this in the web HMI. Here, the date is displayed correctly, and I can see it updating once per second. I have a couple of options here. Personally, I would just ignore this in the preview as an end user will never see it. However, if you need to preview for troubleshooting, you can declare the text variable at the script level, and remove it from the callback. Now my preview will work just fine, and I can continue working. While we have both running, I'd like to point out that the format of date is system dependent. Here, Edge and the preview display the time zone differently. If I want to fix that, I can extend the callback function to perform some more formatting. Maybe I really just want the time and not the full date. Instead of calling date directly, I'll store it as a variable. Then call its function toLocaleTimeString. With the format EN-US for the US Standard Time format. If this sounds useful, I recommend looking up both the date object and the date time format constructor for more information. To test this, we'll run against the preview mode again. It does display the time output by the toLocaleTimeString function, but ignores any arguments passed to it. If I view this in the web HMI though, only the time is displayed as expected. This situation doesn't happen often, but I can't stress enough that code should also be tested in the web HMI before being deployed. That concludes our discussion of the date object. While there are many more details on displaying the time, I'll leave that as an exercise for you. In the meantime, I hope you also have a feel for running program loops to run functions on a schedule. Thank you.